5 ways to use your planner to stop procrastinating. I did a podcast episode on procrastination and how we writers can suffer from this, which might be the reason behind our writer's block. I'm a planner. I have to have a plan, even if things are chaotic, like how life is right now for me. Most of us use some sort of a planning system. Paper, digital, maybe just have important tasks on a piece of paper or sticky notes. Whatever your system is. Today, I want to share 5 actions that you can do to stop procrastinating and get the work done. Number one, carry forward tasks. If you see yourself carrying forward the same tasks for more than 3 days, it's time to look at that task and ask yourself why. Why are you carrying it forward? Is it because it's not important, or is there something more to it? Could it be that you don't know exactly what you need to do next, or maybe the next steps are too big and that's intimidating? Writing a book of 50, 70, 100,000 words is a monumental task. Writing even 5,000 words can be hard, but writing 10 words, then 100 words, then another 100 words, that's not that hard, right? This leads to the next thing you can do, that's break it down. Break your tasks down to just the next task that you need to do. We often procrastinate because we don't know what the next step is, or the next step is too big for us. Identify what is the next step you need to take, just that next step. You need to self-edit your manuscript, but you don't know how to go about it. The next step could be scheduling some time to Google what self-editing entails. Just scheduling the time. That's it. That's your next step. And when that time comes, sitting down and researching the different approaches writers take to self-edit their work, or maybe just finding an editor who shares on their blog some simple tips and tricks that you can implement in your self-editing process. And then the next step would be to make a plan for your manuscript. What is going to be your self-editing process like? And then break it down into small tasks and doing one small task at a time. Make time for those tasks in your calendar. It's important that we hold our writing time sacred and treat it like any other appointment. You have made time to do research for your writing, or maybe for your revisions, or whichever part of the writing and publishing phase you are in. Look at your calendar and make an event and set a reminder so that you know what it is that you need to do and when exactly you need to sit down and do it. And then do it without renegotiating with yourself. That's important. Unless there is something really urgent, and you will know for yourself if you're using an event or something that happens as an excuse, or was it really truly urgent. But treat your writing time sacred and honor it. Set up your environment. You have to set yourself for success, and this includes taking your environment into account as well. Is there something in your environment that gets in your way when it comes to your writing time or when you're working on your book? Is it the distraction of social media or internet in general? Is it your family and friends? What can you do to make sure that there are little to no distractions when it comes to your writing time? I have a little kid, so I can't work on my book when he's awake or when he's around me. So the only time I can work is when he is not around or when he's asleep. So I schedule my whole day in a way that gives me some time to work on my book. Acknowledgements and rewards. Depending on how you work, see if rewarding yourself gives you the high to keep going and keep chipping away at your book. Set some milestones and acknowledge how far you've come and what you have accomplished. It doesn't have to be something big. 15 minutes of guilt-free scrolling time on social media, a coffee date with a friend, just getting something inexpensive for yourself, or even something expensive if that's what makes you happy. I know stationery gets me excited, and that's one of the rewards I use to keep myself motivated and mark my big milestones. The point is to acknowledge that you have overcome a hurdle and that if you did it once, you can do it again. If you're struggling to write and need some motivation, I think you'll like this next video, and I'll see you in the next one.